Many growers prefer clones to seedlings because propagation times are quicker. Plus, you know exactly what you're growing, and the resulting plants are more uniform, making them easier to light efficiently further down the line. But how to clone? Well, the good news is you have options. I'll run through my favorites and splice in a few tips in an Everest fashion along the way. Okay, if you're just starting out, keeping it simple is your surest route to success. The tried and true method is just to get a propagator, tray insert, and some type of propagation plug. Rapid rooters, super sprouter perfect plugs, Grodan AOK starter cubes, root riots, Oasis root cubes, they're all fine. Just make sure they're moist and you're good to go. Personally, I prefer square plugs because they fit my GrowSmart tray better. This fits perfectly into a standard size propagator and raises your cuttings up slightly so that the roots are contained within the plug. Always use a clean blade to take cuttings, and disposable scalpels are ideal. Propagator lid on, vents closed, not too much light. Avoid too much heat, low 70s Fahrenheit or low 20 Celsius. Rooting times can be anything from 4 days to 4 months depending on your species. Now normally you're looking at a week or so, and once you see a bunch of roots poking out of the cube, you're ready to transplant. Aerocloners and deep water cloners are another option and can speed up rooting time significantly. Plus, you can't really beat the speed of taking a cutting and sticking it into a neoprene plug. If you have relative humidity around 50 to 60% or more, you don't even need to use a dome. Just keep your cuttings away from oscillating fans or bright lights. Deep water cloners like this AquaClone 24 site model are the easiest to set up, and it's fairly cheap too compared to most comparable aerocloners. Just fill it with water, position the pump and airline, switch it on, and you're done. It continually oxygenates the water, but like with the aerocloners, be sure that the water doesn't get too warm, okay? 70 to 72 degrees Fahrenheit is optimal. I find the water tends to creep up to your room's temperature after a day or so. So the larger the reservoir, the slower the water temperature creeps up. You can add ice cubes or fashion some sort of chiller device for larger models, but your best bet is to simply put your cloning machine somewhere cooler in the first place. If you're still having issues, try running your pump on a cycle, say 15 minutes on, 15 minutes off. Rooting hormones, gels, and powders? Oh my. Meh, I only use them if I'm having difficulty. Maybe with rosemary, but with basil, there's absolutely no need. This stuff will root in a glass of water, people. For the water you put in your cloning machine, I take my reverse osmosis water and cow maggot up to around an EC of 0.2 or 0.3 or 100 to 150 ppm. The reason I do this is so that my ultra pure water doesn't create osmotic stress on my cuttings and sucks minerals out of them. I pH to just below 6, around 5.8, as I find this encourages the quickest root development. I add rapid start by General Hydroponics. I go very light, usually half what it says on the bottle. After that, I might add a tiny amount of nutrients, usually equal parts of micro grow bloom flora series, but literally just show your cloning machine the bottle and get your ppms up to 300 or an EC of 0.6 max or up to 0.8 or 1.0 for heavy feeding species. Once you have a nice explosion of roots, it's time to transplant. Don't wait until they look like a hippie needing a haircut. And you shouldn't be intimidated by transplanting aeroponic or deep water clones either. Just do what you'd normally do. Make a little hole, pop it in, and carefully and gently surround it with moist growing media. Now's a good time to inoculate my mycorrhizae fungi too. Once transplanted, give them a day or two in low light to get established. Don't forget to clean all your equipment with a high concentration of hydrogen peroxide solution after each cycle, or you're running the gauntlet at a risk for infections. I prefer to sterilize my neoprene pucks too, but some growers just chuck them and start with fresh ones. There you have it. I just wanted to put this out there. If you want more in-depth videos on cloning, then let me know. Similarly, any questions, just deposit them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and my heartfelt gratitude to all you deeply lovable subscribers. Find me on Instagram and even Twitter if you're dying to see what I just posted on Facebook. Time for me to cook some dinner. Adios, amigos. This is EVERESTOUT.